Good evening. Welcome back to Community Crossfire. I'm Councilwoman Zanthia Oliver. I represent the 3rd District. I have some fantastic guests on tonight. I'm going to let them introduce themselves, but everybody in Wilmington knows them. I'm going to start with you know who.
Yeah.
Give your name and your title.
My name is Newdy Felton, co-owner of Influencers Lab, as well as co-owner of Spending Black Matters.
Thank you. Next.
Malcom Coley. I'm also one of the co-owners of Influencers Lab Media, co-owner of Spending Black Matter, and also one of the co-founders of Future Source Gaming.
All right, my name is Alford Campbell, also the co-owner of Spending Black Matters and co-owner of Influencers Lab Media.
Wow, I'm so proud to have you guys on. Y'all have done a lot of great things in the community, continuing to do great things. I just read a nice article about you guys in the paper, and we can speak on that real briefly. Newdy, you obviously received $50,000. Can you explain shortly what that's all about? Because it says video and all that.
Yeah,
so can
yeah.
you tell
so,
me?
So I'm the CMO also of Futures First game. And you know what? Malcom could speak to it. I'm going to let Malcom take on that question.
Malcom, go ahead. Talk to me. I'm sorry.
So we just received the EDGE grant through the Delaware Division of Small Business. And we received $50,000 for our business, Futures First Gaming. And what we're going to be able to do with that funding is we're going to open Delaware's first esports and tech center. That's major, major, major. So when you talk about technology and esports, it can literally equalize everybody across the playing field, whether you're black, white, Asian, whatever. I mean, you know, we focused on our folks.
Right.
But, you know, technology equalizes the playing field. So we just want to create that space where we can actually be the ones that facilitate that equalization.
Let me ask you, when I read it, I was thinking of, is that like the sports games?
Yeah. So yeah, absolutely. So I'm pretty sure
people running in and out and shooting.
Absolutely.
And all that,
so I'm pretty sure you've probably seen kids play a game called Fortnite.
That's what I'm thinking.
Or
of.
You know, Call of Duty, or maybe like an NBA game or Madden. But that's exactly what it is. It's esports. Conceptually, if you're thinking about the NBA or the NFL, just take that same thing conceptually and apply it to video games. So it's the same thing. Just I have a controller in my hand and I'm doing it in a virtual space.
Yep.
Kudos to y'all. When I read it, I kept saying, is that when the, the Fright Night, whatever it is. And I know my nephew plays it a lot. So
right.
I was that's really, kids, and that's a major first in the state of Delaware.
Right, yes. Right. There's a lot of skills that can be taught through esports, and that's what we're here to do, teach those tech skills through esports.
Good for y'all. I have a co-host here, Howard Laws, and he is one of the founders, the original for 720 out Newcastle when if you ever heard of Hands around Newcastle and everybody was out Newcastle, over 1,000 people or more.
Yep.
He is the hitman in charge of that. So now, since he's so involved with Newcastle, I just told him to come on and co-host with me a couple of weeks because he's always talking stuff about Newcastle. And I'm wanting to feel what's going on in Wilmington.
He's gonna
ask you a couple of questions. But first, Newdy, what inspired the creation of Spending Black Matters Group, and how does it reflect the broader historical movement for economic equity and racial justice?
Yeah, so Spending Black, everyone knows about COVID, right? It's something that we couldn't have predicted. Mm-hmm. So during COVID, we realized like we were able to move in a space where we were online. So we realized a lot of our black-owned businesses that had brick and mortars didn't have e-commerce sites. So they were not online. So when a lot of these big chain, these box stores were able to open, a lot of our businesses had to close. So we wanted to create a space where we're able to help them continue to make money, but also recycle our dollars into our community. See, we understand that a lot of the money that we spend, it doesn't go into our communities as it should. So we want to create a space where we know our buying power is you know trillions of dollars. So we want to take some of that money, put it back into our community. But when we created Spending Black, it's a Facebook group online. So we got to date about 33,000 people. Mm-hmm. So what's happening is they're going online and they're spending money with each other. So say, for example, AC is looking for a plumber. They're going to a group and say, I'm looking for a black plumber. And you guys would chime in and give, a black reputable plumber that you know. And these people are making thousands of dollars in our group. And it's amazing. It's a great, great thing.
Well, that would be Matt Williams, I know, from Cool H, which HVAC.
HVAC, okay. Yeah.
You know what I'm talking
about. Yeah.
Is that the right company I'm saying? Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Maybe so.
Okay, but
so.
I just know he's pretty good at that. Yep. I just had to plug that in. Yeah.
Good plug.
Right, good plug.
Good plug.
Okay, Malcom, let me ask you, in what ways does Spending Black Matters utilize digital platforms and community networks to increase awareness and participation in its events and initiatives? I mean, you kind of hit on it, but just
So, you know, when you think about social media, right, that's a huge distribution channel, right?
Okay.
Whereas you can literally spread your message across thousands upon thousands of people. And with our Facebook group, in Spending Black Matters, we do exactly that, right? We have 60% of our folks that's in the group are from Delaware, but that other 40%, they're outside of Delaware. So if you have a great product, you got a great service, all the things, you're able to spread that message digitally, right? Yep. So we talk about Facebook, Instagram, and TikTok or YouTube, right? That's literally allowing you to give your message to people who wouldn't have heard it outside of these platforms. So it's a great way to really get people to know what it is that you're doing, get people to buy your product, or just get people to understand what it is that you're doing and being able to spread that awareness.
Wow, I need y'all to spread my awareness for the third edition, but we're gonna talk about that. We're gonna talk about that a little later.
Real quick, I have to ask this question.
Yes.
Because I hate being around people like you, because now you're starting to talk a language I have no clue what y'all talking about. Real quick, y'all's background, because I love hearing, especially young black males, speak a language so brilliant that I want the public to understand y'all's background and that you know what you're talking about, because your background justifies it. So real quick, your backgrounds.
So I actually graduated from Seton Hall University in New Jersey. I actually have a degree in chemistry. That's a part of my background.
Cool. Yeah. So Howard High School, shout out to the Wildcats.
Wildcats in the house.
Yeah, absolutely. Product of Delaware State University. Shout out to my Hornets. So I'm home team, hometown.
Wow.
So I'm also a product of Delaware State University. Most of my background was in marketing and media. So you know, here I am.
Now, are you the marketing guy for these guys?
It's a collective.
Collective.
We all work
I'm
together.
Proud of y'all.
So proud of y'all.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, don't let Dr. Tony Allen steal y'all.
That's my guy. That's my guy.
Good people.
Speak
good
homies.
Okay. Let me just ask AC a question, then we're gonna go to Mr. Laws's questions. What are the long-term goals in Spending Black Matters, and how do they align with border and visions and economic empowerment for black communities? I want to say, when I was researching y'all, it's a lot going on with y'all, and I'm really impressed.
Yeah, thank you
so much.
Man, it's so much going on. I would say, first off, the plan was to take a lot of the brick and mortars and get them digitalized. Because unfortunately, a lot of people, you know, they shut down, like Newdy was mentioned. We wanted to make sure we gave them the opportunity to still be able to still have that same presence that they had in the store. And when we opened up, we said, okay, let's make sure we give these people, you know, the I guess you want to call it the unheard, the unheard people, a voice to still be able to like stand against the big companies as
Praise
well.
God.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that's good.
Mm-hmm. Awesome, awesome. So partnership and collaboration. How does Spending Black Matters engage with other organizations, businesses, communities, and amplify its impact to reach a wider audience?
That's a good one.
Well, you know, I got to get college drawings.
Two parts. I'll answer first, and I'll let Malcom or AC follow up. So there's, if we know Delaware has so many different organizations, and it's tough for them to reach a lot of the our community. So we bridge the gap between the corporate and the streets. So we have, you know, clients and people that we deal with in orgs on a high level, and we also have people from the street level. So we kind of bridge that gap. So when we have our events, we allow one of our partners is True Access Capital. So they give away, they're CDFI, so they give away non-traditional funding to our community, the underserved community, the minority community. So we set, we do events, we allow them to come in and have a resource table through our email blast. We're sending out blasts to enable our community to have access to those services, because a lot of times they don't know where to find it at. So we become that bridge.
Mm. Yeah.
So success stories, impact measurements. Is there a story that y'all have that defines an individual situation where y'all shown success in what y'all do?
I'll say, so I was talking to a few people that, you know, had just joined, and they were stating that their profits increased or doubled, you know, what it originally was in their brick and mortar. So seeing people have their profits increase and double, that shows, you know, we're doing exactly what we're looking to do for the community. Yeah. So we're definitely, of course, you know, want to build on that and continue to have that same success.
Yeah, you know, I got to ask this question because this is important for young Black people who are listening or watching the show. How do you guys deal with difficulties? Like, when you believe in something that you don't, and he's on the edge, like, how do y'all come together collectively without hating each other for a month and not getting it? Like, what do y'all do when y'all have a conflict? How do y'all work that out?
I tell my friends to punch each other in the face. But I think, well, to be quite honest with you, we rarely have those issues, because majority of the time we on the same page. And if there's those moments where we're not on the same page, everybody, we don't have it. Shout out to Kenyon, because Kenyon's on our, Kenyon Wilson, he's on our team too. Nobody has a problem with bringing that issue to the team. You know, I don't have a problem with bringing something to AC. Kenyon doesn't have a problem with bringing something with Newdy, and Newdy for darn sure don't got no issues.
No egos. We don't listen. We don't have egos, right?
Yeah, like
I can listen to him and I might feel some kind of way, but it's not like it's in a way like where, you know, after we have those disagreements, it's just like, I ain't see it that way.
Yeah.
And I'm like, damn, you know what? I'm mad, but then you're right. You're right. Yeah. So then it's just like, all right, let's keep it pushing.
Good. Awesome.
Especially like, our unit's been around for like, you know, 15 plus years.
Yeah, so we talk to each other every day.
Talk to each other every day. So we cohesive.
Yeah. Right.
So if there's something that I'm not agreeing with Newdy, I'm like, hey, Newdy, look, this is how I feel. Yeah. And I hope you respect it. And he's like, nah, you good. It's just that I felt like this. And now we good. Yeah. And then Malcom would state, you know, his reasoning. And then Kenyon would state his reasoning. And we all heard each other. And we're like, all right, let's move on. Let's put a vote to it. We put a vote to it.
I be losing a lot. They be getting up on me. Yeah. Like 3-1.
We real big on vote.
I be understanding
big on voting.
And that's important. That is important for people who are listening, especially because you get friends who just can't agree on something.
Yeah.
Friendship. And you should keep that. And I brought that question up because I was watching Unsung, and I was watching this history about the Whispers.
Ooh,
and how they said that there was no one person bigger than another. All money's to go in one pot.
Absolutely.
And equally. And one of their members was put in jail for 3 years. And when he came back, his share of the pot was right there with him. So it's good to hear that y'all realize your friendship supersedes everything.
Absolutely.
And all power.
And it goes a lot further, right? Because I know a lot on my own, but there's a lot of stuff that Newdy know. And there's people that Newdy can reach, and there's resources Newdy got that I got. Same thing with AC. AC knows a ton of stuff that I don't know, right? He know a ton of people that I can't physically touch or get in touch with, right? Like I said, it just goes all the way around. Having those yings to your yangs really helps to push any business forward. AC know what I'm good at. I know what Newdy good at. Yep. Newdy know what Kenyon good at, right? So we, although we can cross each other's lanes, we don't cross each other's lanes because it's enough for everybody to get their own.
I like that.
Now, is there an employment possibility with y'all's company where y'all will maybe be hiring people or opportunities?
So right now we have a lot of independent contractors that we use, like graphic designers, website developers, just, you know, as far as like when we get our products made.
I don't have.
We got we know your size, so we ain't, you know. But after this, we're gonna
see our hand out of heart.
But yeah, so like even in terms of right now, like, we're actually looking for intern opportunities, you know, for, you know, some of the, even the high school kids, because there's so many things that we want to be able to teach them what we're doing. And like I said, we're big on giving access.
Yeah.
Like, it's a lot of times where we were coming up, we wasn't awarded the access.
Right.
So we want to be able to give what we didn't get. So if we can help them, they got a t-shirt brand or something like that, we can, you know, send them over to the Gash or Carry My Own Weight or send them to the Steph at Esto, or, you know, like, we're always, you know, looking to give back, and all the resources that we got, we want to be able to, you know, what's ours is yours.
And yeah. You said that, I'm sorry. Gash is doing a really good job with his business.
Gash is doing amazing things over in South Ridge.
Had a friend that had something shipped from overseas, and I'm like, I say, overseas? Say, yeah, my brother brought something. He's over, I think, in Germany. He said, oh, I got something from Carry My Own Weight. And I was like, oh, we're all way over there. So,
and that just goes back to show the impact of social media, right? Because you think about it, if somebody's purchasing something in Germany, how do they see that, right? They're seeing it through their maybe Instagram or Facebook. Mm-hmm. So that just lets you know how powerful social media can be.
I thought that was interesting.
So how many clients do you guys have?
Oh, wow. So to be honest, it varies.
Yeah, it varies.
Depending on the season. Like now, you know, it's political season.
Oh, yeah.
You know, so we don't know what's going on. Some things we might stay out of. You know, but for example, like in the political arena, like we helped Elizabeth Lockman Tizzy. We helped you know, Tizzy get elected back in 2018. We work with United Way. Currently we work with Sweet 411 Black Owned Business, as well as like Keem's, which, you know, he owns both of those you know, spaces. We work
good
with so currently one of our clients is True Access Capital. Our guy, shout out to Van.
I just saw Van coming from breakfast. But I have another question for you. Funding and support, right?
Yes.
How does Spending Black Matters plan sustain its funding model to ensure long-term Black support for Black entrepreneurs and businesses? Mm. I mean, how do long-term, you know, because it's always good. I work with groups that do short-term, but sometimes it's hard as a people in general to get that long-term support.
Yes. So I think we kind of got to, we're in a different space. Okay. Where we haven't just started. We've been doing this for quite some time. Mm-hmm. We're kind of in a conversation where we need to start commercializing and scaling. Okay. And when I say commercializing and scaling, hence putting us in a position to hire folks. Mm-hmm. If we don't hire folks, we're not going to be able to grow, right? We're in this space where not only do we have to hire the people, but we also have to have the system and processes and places for us to make things a lot more seamless. Right. And with that being said, there comes the long term sustainability. Okay. Right. When you have the right standard operating procedures in place and you have the right people who can, for instance, AC needs three people to be him. Newdy needs three people to be him. I need three people to be me. I got those three people. Newdy got those three people. AC got those three people. Now we're really talking about building a business, right?
Well, where's the five people I need for me?
Oh, listen, we got you covered. We can find some folks for you.
Okay, that's all I'm saying.
So, you know, that's where a lot of the long-term sustainability comes in at. And when you talk about digital stuff, right?
Yeah.
How do we create those silos of digital assets that people can consistently gain knowledge from or obtain resources from, and how can they stay in that ecosystem over the sustained period?
In addition, real quick, so also like, so sponsorships, you know, like, so we're also gonna go to a model where a subscription base, where we offer more services for the individual businesses, because we see the need, like there, you know, a lot of our businesses need a various, you know, array of different things. So
back
like we're finding those needs and we're going to fill the void. So like, you know, soon like a subscription model, as well as, you know, other different, you know, various services.
You know, I can remember seeing y'all, you know, years ago, walking around struggling, you know, knocking on the doors, kicking the doors in.
Yep.
And God is good just to see where y'all were. I mean, I could see y'all from 8-9 years ago to now.
Yeah, yeah.
Kudos to y'all.
Thank you.
You know,
and that's
a sign of hard work.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
I mean, nobody gave y'all nothing. Yeah, I don't care what you get now.
They sure didn't. Where the money at? Where y'all at now, man? We here now. Where y'all at?
Right. Because I remember, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I could see all y'all just walking around together trying to figure this out, doing this here. I go to different events, I see y'all over there looking, and y'all figured it out. And that's like, and you know, my brother always says, I'm telling you, you work hard, you will see, you will reap the benefits and not be lazy. And your guys wasn't lazy.
And that consistency.
Yeah, consistency.
Like all those season folk, like y'all they see us all the time. Yeah. You can't not see AC. You can't not see Newdy. They've been looking at Newdy and AC for a long time. I'm the newer one to the squad, right? I'm the newer kid on the block. And you can't not see us. All the rooms that you in, you just happen to see me, or you happen to see AC or Newdy. So what is it about us that you need to kind of like pour into, right?
Consistent.
Yeah, it's consistent.
Yeah, be consistent. Good.
And another thing to touch on what Malcom was just saying, I feel like we've also built great relationships over the years.
Yes.
And I think a lot of those relationships doubled back, you know, in the coming years, and we were able to put it together and say, hey, look.
Well, that's good.
Let's do this.
That's good.
You know what I'm saying? And it all came full circle. Here we are.
Hard work.
Now, do y'all plan on going to any, like, in y'all's field? You're planning on going to any like big conferences or big workshops or big events you could promote your company?
We want to be that. Yeah, we want to be that. So as a yes to answer your question, but we want to be that, right? We are the big conference, right? We are the big workshop. In order to get to this, you got to come through us. That's my mindset of it. Yeah, we absolutely got to go. But we are that at the same time. So one of those things is where we're looking at them as like a higher tier. Nah, you are peer because we are that. Yeah.
Mm. Last question. How does Spending Black Matters incorporate businesses, community, matter incorporate community's feedback into strategies and programs? And how does feedback shape the evolution of this group over time?
Yeah. I would say we're constantly like we get a lot of people make, you know, a lot of suggestions of what we should do with the group. And, you know, a lot of times I feel like a lot of businesses fail because they don't listen to the consumer. Mm-hmm. Right. So like we're always constantly listening to what like upgrades or things that we're not doing. And we don't take it as like, you know, negativity. We take it as like, you know, if the consumer's, you know, saying this is what we want, this is what we need, if we give it to them, then we're fulfilling the void. We're constantly, you know, asking for feedback and just constantly, you know, sharpening our tools and you know, making sure that, you know, we're elevating like the things that we're doing.
You know, we have a few more minutes and how we're gonna ask this question, starting with you, AC, because it's Black History Month.
Yes.
Give me one or two names of individuals who inspired you, Black History Month. One or two, could be a relative or just whoever, just one, two names, just the names, not why.
So I'll say one person, well, the two people, one would be Kevin Hart.
Okay.
And another one would be...
I'm going to come back to you.
Yeah, come back. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, Newdy. Come on, Newdy.
What about
Newdy?
Oh, no. Malcom ready.
Newdy, I'm talking to you. Give me one or two names.
So I would say that inspired me. So this is the Godfather. His name is Clarence Avant.
Mm-hmm. That's right.
Man, he like when I seen his story.
That's right.
I'm like, yo, that's me.
Like, talk about it.
Because he was in every sector. Like it was, you know, he was in,
everything.
Music, politics, business, and I feel like the same trajectory what I'm on. I see myself in him, and of course, I would say, Jay-Z. Mm-hmm. You know, because he showed us. Growing up, like I lived through his music. He taught me a lot of business terms that I didn't even learn in school, and I learned through his moves and you know how he kind of progressed. Wow. And I'm like, and I was doing something like he was at his music was actually like you know like a I don't want to say like a Bible, but like it was you know it showed me exactly what I should do, and I took that. And I mean like those two guys, I'm super inspired by.
All right, give me two.
For me, God rest his soul, but Nipsey Hussle was a huge, he is a huge inspiration for me because, you know, I'm super big on tech and he was able to, before his passing, he was really in a position where he was starting to really integrate hip hop with technology. So I was really, even to this day, I'm still figuring out more and more about, you know, what Nipsey Hussle did for the culture. And then, man, I just love 50. 50 Cent is like my guy. You know, we take a step back from his social media antics, right? Mm-hmm. But his acumen as a businessman is wants some to be touted amongst the greats. So, you know, 50 Cent is a huge inspiration for me. Like I said, outside of the, you know, the petty stuff that he posts on social media, he is an intelligent and brilliant businessman. Somebody who, you know, I would love to absolutely partner with one day.
Well, what about you, Mr. Moss? Two names that comes to your mind.
I'm waiting for him.
Oh.
Because I want to know if he's, is he the comedian of the group?
No.
He's saying hey, Kevin
see,
Hart.
Hey, see the dancer, though. Hey, see the dancer, though. Look, Happy
well, look,
Feet.
Well, look, yes.
We got 2 minutes.
So, Kevin Hart and the other one was Master P. Oh. Master P created, like, one of the, like, biggest impacts, I feel like, in music history. And was able to, like, duplicate that. And move it on to movies, film, and like
cereal.
Like it's just so crazy to watch him, you know, grow from, you know, he started in the trunk.
Right.
He started in the trunk of his car.
Yeah, look at what he's working.
Became this big mogul. So yeah.
Okay.
You know, for me, and he is, and of course everyone has the right to their opinion, the greatest impactful person in my life is Wilt Chamberlain.
Okay.
And I'm gonna tell you why. Because when Wilt was in MEA, it was 1% black. And he showed me that if we take their rules and dominate using their rules, they're going to have to change it. But when they change it, they're going to have to sit us down with them when they change. And Wilt Chamberlain went into a white sport like basketball, because it was a white sport, and dominated to where they changed the game thinking it was going to make it better for them. And that's why today NBA is 92%
black. Talk about it. Talk about it. Give me like one more person. You got two. You got another person.
You got to get one after that one.
That was strong.
What about you, Ms. Anthony?
Okay, no, I'm going to give you mine. I got a couple. Every week I'm giving something up. So one would be my grandmother, Lillian Oliver, who was an activist who ran against Herman Holloway Sr. Back in the day when that was unheard of for women to run against a senator.
Right.
And he was the icon in the state of Delaware, and he was a senator.
Right.
And because of her, Wilmington Hospital was still open. Herman Holloway Jr. could tell you the story better than me because he was there. He lived there. I was younger. But because of her advocacy and getting people together, and that's why we do so much together opposed to we do better as a group opposed to in silence, right?
Yes. Yep.
She was able to get people together and walk over to the Wilmington Hospital and do a march. And to today, because they was going to close it down and just have Christiana Care. This was when they was closing down Wilmington, just have Christiana Care here in Wilmington. And my grandmother, with her folks, individuals like y'all, getting all them people together, talking about the same thing. We needed a hospital in Wilmington. And because of Lillian Oliver, Wilmington Hospital is still open. So, yeah. And my brother, Storm and Norman. Very impactful, right? He's my godfather. So you say that movie, I read the book, he's a bad boy. So Storm reminds me, when you said that, it just gave me chills, right? When he died, I cried. You know, when I read it, and I was like, when his wife was like, I feel like a part of the family, right? So what Storman was able to do, coming from Wilmington, middle class, then went into projects, or whatever circumstances, and came out of that and always fed people. And then he came up with this idea. He went to Delaware State when people counted him out, head of the class, you know, class president, you know. So goes to hard work because he's up early in the morning reading. And people don't know he was an actor in school. Then he comes, and then he comes up with this Storm's Classic, and he's one of the ones, and so many, and after that, I mean, it just goes on and on and on. Chair of the Democratic Party, still relevant to the day when a lot of people aren't, you know. So when people want something done, they pick up the phone and he can make a call. And, you know, it's nothing wrong with that. It's nothing wrong with black people in position. It's nothing wrong with you being able to know the 10 people that he don't know and you know. And we got to stick together. So this is real impactful right here. And I feel real warm, you know, because it's okay to make some money and buy a new car. It's okay to buy a house, to take care of your kids and take care of your nieces and nephews when we didn't have it like that. So we want to stand on people's shoulders and pass this on. So let me talk about how good God is.
You know,
talk about
my greatest Clarence Avant story ever is when Hank Aaron was getting ready to get his home run back.
Yes. Talk about it.
He didn't know
the CEO of
Coca-Cola.
Yep.
Didn't even know who the guy was.
Yeah. Talk
went
about
straight
it.
In his office on, and said man. To him, Negroes, and then he didn't use the word Negro. Negroes drink Coke too.
Yep. That's right.
You're gonna give Hank Aaron a deal.
He was
deal.
That man. He How about that? Man.
And he gave it to him. Just didn't even know
it.
The man.
That was it.
So and sometimes that's the power that we have to have.
Yes.
We can't ask. Sometimes it's important that we demand.
And it's nothing wrong with sometimes.
And it's nothing wrong.
And it's something. And I like what you just said, because sometimes it's nothing wrong with being a little hostile. Some people, she's this. No, sometimes you don't agree with stuff.
Yeah.
I mean, okay, you could write about me all day. If I disagree, I disagree.
Yeah, right. Yeah.
I mean, that's what a democracy is. We're not going to always agree. Yeah. And I say that to say, I'm in this position because of the people. Mm. I'm not in this position because of me. If it wasn't for them, I wouldn't be in it. So I stand up on the people. I advocate for the people.
We
I wear my sneaks and I got high heel, red bottoms on it, but I put my sneaks and boots and I work hard.
Work.
So I appreciate y'all coming on.
Absolutely. We appreciate
God bless
you.
Last thing, can we close out with the Spending Black Matters?
Oh, February 24th. The third annual Spending Black Matters pop-up shop is
going to
be at, shout out to Aaron Bass, Eastside Charter.
Over
in Riverside. We in the hood with it.
My third district.
Shout out to all the dope stuff that's going on in third district. You got Logan Heron over there, Team Warehouse, Reach Riverside, and you got my man Markevis with the Nerd It Now Warehouse. So then you got Aaron Bass. He's building a $26 million STEM hub over at Eastside Charter. So that's really going to make a huge impact with the community over there. But that's where we chose to land this spaceship at, you know, and we're probably going to do it there this year and next year.
So I know we ain't got that much time. Tickets?
Go to spendingblackmatters.com.
Go to spendingblackmatters.com
to register for free.
It's free. It's completely free.
Free event.
Yes.
Now, but if you're a vendor, you got to pay some money.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
spendingblackmatters.com/vendors2024. Go if you want to register as a food vendor. We still need vendors. We need some food vendors.
We only got a couple left.
Yeah, we don't have a lot left. We still need a few. We don't have a lot left. So hurry up, get there.
Last year we did over 600.
Is there a telephone number?
AC.
You can call me at 302-690-1050.
All right. Thank you so much for coming on.
Thanks for having us.
Thank you for
having us. Such a pleasure.
And we will be back next week with Storm and Norman with Community Crossfire. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Got to pay back. Revenge.
Welcome back to Community Crossfire. I'm Councilwoman Zanthia Oliver. I have a special guest on tonight. She really doesn't need any introduction, but I'm going to let her introduce herself and tell us her title.
Hi, my name is Dr. Daniece Hubbard-Brown.
And your title?
I am the CEO of Ultimate Scholastic Staffing Solutions, known as US in the community. So.
Oh, thank you for coming on. I really appreciate you.
Thank you for having me.
So I know the name of your company, and what do you do in various school districts?
Right now, I staff school districts for their substitutes and their call-out rates. So if schools call out, they will contact my company, and we'll fill their needs for substitutes, paras, one-on-ones, 504s, anything they need. Our job is to help support the school district.
Let me ask you a question. I wrote down a couple of questions to ask you. Do y'all deal with the cafeterias? Because I know somebody had called me. I sent a couple people to you, but you do have cafeteria staff?
Yes, anything dealing with the educational system, so cafeteria, bus aides, people that hold the stop sign at the front, crossing guards. We have cafeteria. We have, as well as cleaning. We just got a contract for cleaning, so they actually clean our schools. Oh. Shout out to Odyssey Charter School for that contract. Thank you. Uh-huh. And it's a big school, so we help support that school,
too. Oh, great. Where are they located?
Odyssey's on Lancaster near the new Wegmans. It's a gorgeous campus. It's about five buildings. It's really big. It's kindergarten through 12th, and they're actually enrolling.
Oh, that's really nice. So that's what you do for a living? Because you're entrepreneur in another arena. What else do you do?
I do staffing. I do a lot for the community, so I give back a lot.
Do you do sneakers?
The sneakers came from my son, 302 King's Kick. Mm-hmm. During the pandemic, he was just like, want to wear sneakers every day, and then he was coloring on them. So I was like, Kaden, let's just sell sneakers. So we was at the mall every day getting sneakers, and then from there, he started making a profit.
I remember that, and I thought that was interesting that you, as a parent, you know, took on what his son wanted to do and started him doing his entrepreneur at an early age, because a lot of people, especially minorities, don't get their kids involved with the entrepreneurship. But it really shot off, you know. Saw you on Facebook, Twitter. I was like, oh, they're really doing good.
It shocked me. Like, and he's 13 years old now, and his proceeds go to his education. The goal is for him to go to school debt-free, so that's the goal. And his piggy bank is stacking. That's right. 13 years old. Like,
wow. And he's a handsome little fella.
Thank you.
What's your typical day? What's a typical day like in your shoes?
Typical day, I wake up every morning at 3:00.
Okay.
Every morning. I love Oprah Winfrey. I listen to something motivated by Oprah Winfrey every single morning, whether it's a quote, whether it's a saying, and I look at my phone and send it out to at least 5 people. Then the day hits. That's when the school districts start calling me, and I have to fill their needs. And that's can go all the way up until 10:00 in the afternoon.
Wow.
Yes, and I go to bed every night at 8:00, but I wake up every morning at 3:00.
Okay, so that's pretty much like my schedule. I'm up every morning around 5:00, and I go to bed around 9 or 10-ish. So
early birds get the worms.
That's right. That's right.
Yes.
What do you think your company? Where do you think your company is headed in the next 5 years?
The next 5 years, my goal is anything I put my mind to. I sat back and reflected on it. Anything I put my mind to, I conquer it.
Okay.
Like, I conquer it no matter what. My next goal in the next 5 years is to staff Amazon. That is my biggest goal, is to staff Amazon. I know I'm currently supporting school districts, but I want to support these other companies, such as Walmart, Amazon. I want to be a staffing agency, a company similar to Kelly. That's who I kind of like piggyback and reflect at. When you look at our competitors in the market, it's Kelly, it's ESS, it's other companies that's doing an amazing job out there. But Kelly's been around for years, but they staff everything. And I'm young, I'm African-American, and I want to conquer.
Oh, my God. That's really good. I look forward to working with you.
Thank you.
I look forward to working with you, working for you. You can sit up. He has it. Let me say another thing. What is your I know you have some upcoming events. What is one of your main big upcoming events?
My big upcoming events, so I really strive myself on back to school because it's a part of my company, which is we deal with school districts. So my upcoming event that I have planned is a back to school event. I want to do it for the whole week, so from August 19th to the 24th, sponsored and supported by the Women's Empower, along with USSS. It's going to be a big event. You must be there. Your children must be there. Everything is free, other than the concert, but it's ways you can get to the concert for free admission. But I can't announce the artist yet because you have to be there. But
that's
it's from August 19th all the way to the 24th. So it's Monday through Saturday, a big event all week for children to come and enjoy themselves, network, and it's going to be epic. So just stay tuned for the announcements.
All right. I'm looking forward to that. And we'll discuss that a little bit in depth offline, because maybe I can definitely be, I would like to be one of the sponsors.
Thank you. I would love that.
What are some of your strengths and weaknesses when it comes to your company? And, you know, I know you're fairly new in this field, but you're moving rather fast. What are some of your strengths and weaknesses?
Yes. Yeah, I've been in business for 3 years. 3 years.
Wow, has it been three years?
3 years. 3 years.
Good for you.
So 3 years like a baby. They still growing. They
right,
still,
yeah.
They, you know, they just learn how to walk. So a little stumble here and there. So every day is not perfect. Mm-hmm. You know, I'm learning to take deep breaths, and every day is not perfect. So that's what I'm noticing. On my, that's my weaknesses, is realizing that every day is not perfect.
That's right.
Because I challenge myself. My strength is that I keep going every day, no matter what the challenge is. I want to keep going. I never am going to stop. Why? Because what drives me that I'm never going to go back.
That's right.
When I say go back to where I came from, which is the community, I'm from West Side, 5th and Madison. And I chose to break my family curse and chain. Mm-hmm. It's like a merry-go-round. I hopped off.
Praise
and
God.
I don't Praise no God. Longer... want that. I want my son to grow up different than what I grew up with.
Praise God.
So that what drives me every day too, and that's a strength as well.
And I like that. You know, some people think they have to stay stuck in, you know, what the family did or what the cousin did, and you know, whatever it may have been. And you chose to take another avenue, another path, and you know, you're showing your son another path. And, you know, I used to hang on the West Side. You got certain areas of town that yes. wasn't always pleasant to grow in. It
wasn't pleasant.
In. But that's good that you have overcame it and you're doing very successful. How many, what's the ages that you, your company works with? Is it youth, teenagers?
It's youth. It's from kindergarten to high school.
Okay.
We staff kindergarten through high school, but the age for us to come work with me, mm-hmm. You have to graduate high school. You must have a bachelor's degree. Not bachelor's degree, high school diploma or up. You must pass a criminal background check. You must have a child protective registry, pass that, because we don't want anybody working in our schools, as well as a TB test. So those are the screenings to pass in order to come work for us. Yeah.
Just a high school or GED?
Yes.
Oh, yep. That's not bad.
Yeah.
So tell me some of the schools that you work in.
So I'm all the way up north. I just got into Pennsylvania, which is Chester, and I'm all the way down to Dewey Beach.
Oh, there
yes.
you go.
Yes.
So you're saying about 10 schools or 8 schools?
No, that's school. So districts, I'm in
it's
three.
Different districts.
Yeah, within a district, it's 3 districts. And I'm learning as this, so I'm learning to crawl before I can walk. But districts are big. Like when I got the contract for Christiana School District, I didn't know Christiana has almost 30 schools.
Right.
So that was like a big shocker to me, but I'm proud of myself because I stayed up all night to write that contract, and then I got that email and saying, you got it. So big
that
shout out
relief,
to Christiana
right?
School District,
Praise
yes.
God.
And Mr. Pritchett, you know, his wife is an amazing woman, her and Sherry Manlove. We have, you always have to have a motivator in your corner, and they're women as well. That Mr. Pritchett's not here with us today, but they was always in my back pocket that I could have called literally until this day. I still do call when I have trouble moments in my company. Mm-hmm. They've been around for years.
Yeah,
they've been doing it for about 30
me.
Years.
Yeah.
And they taught me the rope. You know, and shout out to Mr. Ronnell Page. He did show me the way. But along that, when we went our own parts and ways, I always had another mentor in my back pocket, which was Ms. Manlove and Mr. Pritchett. And until this day, his wife, I salute to her. She's just a phone call away, both of them.
Just as nice as she wanted to be, both of them. So, wow, you couldn't have, no wonder you're so successful. You're talking about Mr. Marvis Pritchett, Pritchett Associates. I mean, they opened the door for all minorities to get into school districts. I used to work for them for years. They helped me with my business. I mean, just some really lovable people, one of a kind.
Yes.
They're jewels.
And she keep me going. She's like, it's okay. It's yeah, okay. You're going to keep going.
It's not
okay.
going to be perfect, like
it's
you
not
said.
Perfect.
It's not going to be perfect. So do you have... do you hire women and men, or it doesn't make a difference?
It doesn't make a difference. Women, men, all race. Big shout out to Ms. Sabrina Purnell. She's doing a great job recruiting for our Spanish population, Latino and Spanish. So that is a big demographic that we're touching. That's down in Appalachian School District, so we actually supporting that.
Downstate.
Appo, Middletown. Middletown. Mm-hmm. Yep, Appalachian School District.
Wow, that is, tell me something else about your company, Us. It's USSS. I like
yes.
that.
Yes,
and that's
Us.
Like Us with the community.
Yes.
All over demographic, just throughout the whole state. So that's beautiful. I like that. I like that name.
Yeah, we're a good company. It's a great company to work for. Come join the movement because we're growing. and we're not going to stop.
Is that your slogan? Because you said that
join
last
the
night.
Movement. Join okay. the movement. I okay. tell everyone to join the movement.
I like that.
Join the movement because we're growing. Right now, I staff about 510 people every single day. Every single day, literally. It varies from 450 to 510 and working every day. And that is overwhelming.
That's
a typical
a
day like me is overwhelming. Cause you have to I'm honored to be able to put almost 500 people to work every day.
Minority contractor. And you know what?
African American.
Yes, and I'm just so used to seeing you moving and you've always been busy. So I'm not surprised. So this plus you need something like that to keep your energy.
Yes. And I hate cell phones, to be honest. People be like, so what is my biggest thing I don't like? Is cell phones. I don't like cell phones. My phone rings constantly. But being in this field, it's just it changes.
You have to.
You have to. I love it.
Yeah. I mean, especially when you got all these different, you know, people working for you. You have to look at your phone, right?
People walk up to me in the grocery store. Hey, Dr. Howard. Hey, Dr. Howard. You know, I work for you. School. Like, hi. Thank you.
So, just
to see the smile that I'm able to bless families with. You know, they putting food on our table, electric, paying our bills, and their everyday needs to survive.
It's a big blessing.
So, and I don't want to let people down. So I don't want to let nobody down. Can you imagine staring 500 some people in the face and saying you don't got nowhere for them to go?
That's right.
So that's what motivates me to keep them working.
I'm just so happy for you. And your mother and your father, they do such a good job.
Thanks.
I've been knowing them. The Purnells from South Bridge on Claymont Street.
All of them.
Yeah, we grew up on Claymont Street, and you're talking about Onita.
The Carters.
Yeah, my God, you just have a whole slew. And you have two slews of people. I know all of them, so
yes.
God is good. So you come from good genes, you know,
Thank you.
Both sides. So, you know, hardworking people, and, you know, I'm just proud of you being an African American young lady entrepreneur doing your thing. We have a few more minutes. Tell us a little bit more. You go ahead, feel free to give us some. What's one of your highlights stories? I mean, you have one or two good highlight stories that you like to? Success stories, I mean.
Success stories. I just want to say to anybody out there, if people tell you you can't do it, do it, and it can be done still. Don't let nobody stop you from your growth or your dreams. So one of my biggest highlights in my life, I don't want to say it's in my story, in my life is graduating with my bachelor's degree from Virginia State University on time, being a student athlete, couldn't play softball no more as a student athlete, class president of my class, lost the title of being a class president because you was childless. You have to be childless. And I had my son, and people don't know, I had my son my junior year in college. And I graduated on time with my son walking across that stage. So that's a big highlight for my life to graduate.
When they counted me out,
my son was at every class. The teacher had him, you know. And I had some cries along the way because it was like to get the denial letter, you can't run for, you know. I always wanted to be the class president to speak at my graduation, and I carried my class for 3 years.
That was one of the stipulations. You couldn't have children.
Being a part of SGA, you cannot have children.
Ain't that something? Times have changed. I'm sure they changed that. Back then, look at the struggles we had to go through. People had to go through.
It was a struggle.
Wow. So now you go back there and say, now look.
Yeah, 3.8 GPA. And that's my next, Petersburg, Virginia. So, I do have a few schools down there, two schools in Petersburg, Virginia, but that's growing.
Mm-hmm.
Shout out to my organization that I'm a part of in Virginia. They manage that site down there.
Good.
So when my business is in different states, I'm trying to get 50 states, but that's a minute. But
that's
I do have people down there who runs it and manage it for me. So
it's good.
It feels good.
Talk about a story. I'm just looking forward to the day when you call me up and say, I wrote a book.
Everyone is telling me to write a book.
Yeah.
So if I started to write a book, to be honest, it's called The True Black Barbie. I know everyone see me with makeup on and I look beautiful, but behind the makeup, when I go home and take this off, there are scars.
Mm-hmm.
There are scars. What people don't know is I was adopted.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks to my mom and dad who took me in like no other. Like,
mm-hmm.
I was adopted and I came from nothing, but my story will be called The True Black Barbie. So stay tuned. It may be coming.
True Black Barbie. It's coming.
Everybody, write a book.
I know it's coming. I'm going to be right there at the book signing.
Thank you.
And make sure.
I hope Oprah read it one day, because that's my idol so much.
Oh, yeah, definitely. Oprah. She will. Well, you're going to be that Oprah for us in Wilmington.
Yes, and you know? I'm going to be it, trust me.
I already know you are. So I'm trying to think of some upcoming events that's going on. We have, I have a birthday party coming up March the 16th.
Going to be 25?
Something like that. I'll be 25. And I support the Monday Club because it's the oldest black members club in the country. So they used to be on French Street years ago. Now they're on Newcastle Avenue. So I try to support minority businesses. And that's going to be on Wednesday, March the 14th, and it's from like 6 to like 9 to 10, because people have to get up and go to work. So we go out there and support the Monday Club on Wednesdays. It gives us something to do, get the fellowship, and then you don't have to worry about no rhetoric because the police are right upstairs. But it's just a mature crowd. So we'll be having a birthday small party out to the Monday Club, giving away some of Ampy's favorite things. And that will be from 6 o'clock to like 9:30, 10 is pushing it. Because like I said, we'd be out there by 10 because people have to get up and go to work. So I want to say that. Also, I'm going to be giving away, I have cases and cases of children vitamins that the twin Devin and Darren Parks gave me. They work downstate and they get a lot of things. So they was call me and give me stuff. So I will be giving them to Dr. Williams at Stubbs School.
Okay.
And now that I know you're working with some kids, well, I already know that, I make sure I give you something to give out to some of the
people. Yes, I will.
Just kids' vitamins. And vitamins are high. You're talking about, so I have cases and cases of them. And you're talking about...
it's needed.
And I mean, vitamin C's and they're the chewables. I mean, I think it's $15.95 just a bottle. I mean, for us, it's $20.
The Flintstones when I was growing.
That's right. That's right. So I have a lot of them. I'm going to be doing a press release, and we should be giving them out next week, and I'll make sure I give you some.
Please do. I'll be there. And anything you are a part of that you would like USS to be a part of, we give back. So that's one thing about our company. We give back. So anything people want to do, we give back and support it.
Okay. I'll make sure I look you
keep
up, because I'm always looking for some support, every now and then.
We're here.
Because I don't mind supporting anybody. We got a few more minutes. Anything else you want to share with us?
You can always log on to our website. Those out there who want to apply, USS.com. Click, log on, apply, submit your resume. Every Wednesday from 6:30, we're at the Wilmington Pal doing on-the-spot interviews every Wednesday at 6:30 p.m. So spread the word. We're on social media, Instagram, USS on Instagram, as well as Facebook.
So that's every Wednesday at the
every
Pal.
Every Wednesday at the Wilmington Pal at 6:30, business casual. Business casual.
Okay.
Business casual, on-the-spot interviews. And we're actually working on a coat closet, like a clothes closet, where if you don't have clothes, you can come get some clothes for your next day to work and look very presentable. Because I know it's a struggle for some people to provide clothes. There's times I told people, employees, to get in the car, meet me at Walmart, go and find a week worth of clothes, or just 2 days worth of clothes, and make it work. A khaki and nice slack.
Because tell people them khakis take you a long
khakis
way.
Khakis take you a
shirt.
Long way.
Yeah, that's all you need.
Because in this world today, people are just judgmental on things. Just wear a khaki and a nice shirt. So
that's it.
Every Wednesday. So come to the Wilmington Pal, 6:30, every Wednesday night.
Thank you. So, Daniece, tell me your whole name again.
Daniece Mary Hubbard.
And how you spelling that?
DanicePhubbard. Oh, hyphen Brown. I'm a Brown now.
Okay, that's right. Your wedding was fabulous.
Oh, thank you.
I've been to several of your events.
Proposal. You was there when I got engaged to.
On the yacht. So we really had a nice time, and I really appreciate you.
Thank you for having me.
I respect you, and I look up to you. I'm just impressed, and I love the work. I always try to encourage people. You know, some people be hating on people or just for no reason.
We all can win.
I encourage people to do better. We all should be encouraging each other. It's not many of us doing a whole lot, but there is many of us, but we're not in the majority of, with businesses, et cetera. And it's always extra hard when you're a minority, period. Especially an African American, a female on top of that. African American female, you already got strikes against you. And to see that you have overcome all the above, I'm just happy and proud of you.
Thank you.
I mean, I really, I just love you. And you keep
love
up
you
the
too.
Good work.
Thank you.